Hello, Internet! Vinny D here, broadcasting you live from the fortress of Fragitude. Today we return, for the third time, for the last time, to beating Gux. So, if you're wondering why I'm saying the third time, this is my third attempt at beating it. Actually, I've succeeded twice already, but got really shitty videos out of it. So, hopefully, this is the last time. I'm gonna show you guys the ending of Ghost. Because not having defeated my opponent is like having a bone stuck in my throat. I just can't go on living. You may also notice the music now does not sound like Balls. I'll shut up for a second. Yeah, apparently the weird music was on my end. I've since fixed the problem with sound through wine. And now we can finally play this damn game as it was meant to be played. So let's get to it. Yeah, now that's how pixel soundtracks should sound. That's some good vertical shooting up here. Hopefully this won't take me too long, because I know most of this game's dirty little tricks. Like these guys sneaking up from behind. Not falling for that anymore. So if you're wondering if I've kept shooting the face, the creepy, eyeless, screaming baby face, without destroying the turrets, the eye would have come out and started attacking with that while the turrets were still there. You may have also noticed I found another little secret. Keep shooting the weak point of the boss after you kill it, and you get a shield. This made a huge difference. Really like this game. There's a lot coming at me, but it kind of reminds me of the Meteo stage in Star Fox 64, only in 2D. Actually, an overhead shooter 2D Star Fox would be kind of awesome. I know it would sort of defeat the purpose of Star Fox being one of the first true 3D games, but it would still be kind of cool. We can call it Star Fox, the second dimension. Okay. Do a barrel roll! Use the brake! Use the boost to get through! By the way, if I destroy that creepy face-looking rock, there's a special weapon, and I missed it. But I didn't particularly want it anyway. It's not a very good weapon. The machine gun is much better for bosses. And if I chill right here, those missiles can't hit. Fireballs can, though. This boss has 2 weak points, and that means 2 shields. And at level 3, you get these orbits. But I lose my shield. So it's kind of a trade-off. However, I can still pick up one more and have shield on top of orbits, which is really awesome. Double machine gun. Machine guns. Metal Slug 5. Anybody? Anybody at all? Am I the only one who remembers that game? Yes, sir. Well, you're missing out. Because you could get 2 machine guns. And the tank turned into a giant robot. Metal Slug, a weapon to surpass. What do you have to do that thing? I was just doing that for fun. Yeah, these orbiters both damage enemies and stop projectiles. And as long as you don't die, you never lose them. Now if I'm careful, these things will never shoot at me. I'm gonna stick with the double more shield, level 4. And from here on out, they just give you bonus points. And and I fly right through the corpse of my freaking battle. Harpoon, one of the game's very best weapons, if not the best. I'm going to try and keep this. This level has a lot of shit coming at me. Ooh, saved by the shield. God damn it. This will be tough, but I can get that weapon back. So my shield is gone forever. Like the dinosaurs. Not coming back. God damn it. That fireball would kill after. Oh, son of a bitch. If I lose all my lives on this one level, I'm gonna be pissed. But this will not be a rage quit video. We're talking no sleep till clear. Harpoon? What the hell? That's bullshit. That was Jack! That was Jack from Cave Story! Did you see that? Go back and pause. That was awesome! Not dying there, I mean, the little Cave Story Easter egg. It was a nice touch. See if I can find that. What the hell? I just flew right into that. Nope, not Spore Attack. Damn it. Didn't mean to do that. Okay, starting over. This game still manages to surprise me in places. Machine gun. Heavy machine gun. Okay. even more. One boss, once again. I mentioned once before I heard there was a planned 3DS release of this game, only with better graphics. Was supposed to be released digitally on the eShop. I've even found reviews of it out there. But aside from advanced copies, it didn't ever seem to actually materialize on the eShop. I don't know whatever happened to that. Nicholas was handling the port. So, Nicholas, get your shit together. I lost my shield already. I need to get my shit together. How did I just dodge a power-up? God damn. I have just become ass-carded today. You are watching a Let's Play made by an idiot. Son of a bitch. The worst part about dying is getting knocked back to the shitty starting level. If this takes more than an hour, I may edit this video down. No one wants to watch me die. Random thought. Prior to the advent of video games, I'm guessing the phrase, I died, was not used very often. Show you this weird weapon, the anchor. It shoots wherever you were. Oh god damn it! I just got killed by a power-up. I got killed by a fucking power-up. I am an idiot. I reiterate. I don't know why you're watching this, but you are watching a Let's Play made by an idiot. I am an idiot, a moron, and a dumbass. Thank you. sons of bitches. Multiple consecutive sons of bitches. Well, if I was going to game over, good that it's relatively early in the game instead of right near the end. Less time wasted that way. And that was not it. That was the zone of being in front of a fucking fireball. That was the zone of me being a moron. The lousy thing is, there are no power-ups past this game. Figures, beating this game twice already, can't get past the first goddamn level now that I can actually get a good video in. The bad thing is I'm getting more frustrated than I would with a much harder game, because I know I've already beaten this one. And that's what's driving me frickin' crazy. Who did the guy I go with? Huh, you thought you had me. You didn't have shit. Me, least of all, the shit. Let's stick with this weapon and see if it makes a difference. It's got a decent range of fire. Yeah, I think the machine gun racks up damage a little faster. We'll be right back. game would be a lot easier if it let me use the D-pad. I'm kind of stuck with the analog stick. I don't know why. Actually, I've noticed that with a lot of 2D games, especially on Steam. You would think they should use the D-pad, but they only recognize the analog stick. Wondering if I had destroyed that other fireball launcher before destroying the first die, I would have had to start dealing with the health earlier. Level 4 shield. Best gun in the game. Could you get Jack to show up? Started to reveal it, but had to dodge away. I think I read somewhere that there's a secret weapon in this game, so I'm guessing if I could have actually picked them up, that's how I would have gotten it. I don't want either one of them. That's how I screwed up a previous playthrough, losing the harpoon. Boss time! This is now further than I've gotten on the previous playthrough. That is the one on YouTube. Well, and my previous account on this one. Lost my shield, but I'm still alive. This one always runs away. Never kill it. I don't know, is there a story to this game? Come to think of it. You know, in a lot of shooters, okay. This is a tricky stage. It's hard to see everything that's coming at you due to the background. Better shoot. As I was saying, in a lot of shooter games, the game is either named after the ship or after your enemy. Like, Gallagher. The ship isn't called Gallagher. The alien invaders are called Gallagher. Kind of like Space Invaders, the very first shooter. However, in the case of Gradius and R-Type, it is named after the ship you're flying. Coming up on the boss now. I already have the full power shield. So I don't have to lose my heart. That is some true bullet hell. In Gradius, Gradius is the name of the ship. Same with R-Type. More specifically, as the name would imply, it's a whole line of ships. The R-Type ships. Get the good ending, you rescue some other archives that were sent in. This is where the boss gets tricky. And it's true bullet hell territory. Got it. Die. Die. Die, boy, you dead. You dead, boy, you dead. I kill you. I kill you. Ha ha. Victory. And that is the end of Gust. My advice, once you get the harpoon, do everything in your power to keep it. Best gun in the game. So, I'm wondering, am I the Gux? Is the Gux the ship? Is Gux the collective name for the bad guys I'm fighting? Which I notice are all eyeballs, except for those tile enemies right near the end. Is Gux the enemy commander? Is that why the tank in level... Four, I think? Yeah, level four ran away? Did he retreat to command the final boss? Was that Guts? Who is Guts? What is Guts? I don't know. Doubt this game even has a story. But anyway, game beaten. For the final time. Yeah, those are the one things that don't have eyeballs in this game. Killer mailboxes. Screaming face thing. Two eyeball H crab thing. Immobile tank threat thing. Tank that runs away with Morningstar's thing. And whole bunch of eyeballs glued together thing. Strange that the credits are in Japanese, but the entire rest of the game is in English. Kinda wonder about that. In any event, that is Guxed. At long last defeated. With what I hope to God is finally a good video capture. So, with all that said and done, this is Vinny D. Out.